Hi everyone, welcome to the online classes DO Nalgonda, 10th class English medium, mathematics, trigonometry. What is trigonometry? Trigonometry is one of the branches of mathematics. Mathematics has so many branches: arithmetic, mensuration, algebra, statistics, calculus, geometry, coordinate geometry. This way, so many branches. Among these branches, trigonometry also one of the branch of mathematics. So, this trigonometry is the word which is derived from two Greek words. Those are trigonon and metron. Two Greek words. So, trigonon means triangle. Metron means measurement. Measurement of angles. And the measurement of relation between the angles and sides, that is studied by this trigonometry. If the angles are changed, the ratios of the sides also changed the same way, the same ratio. Especially this trigonometry is related to only right angle, triangles. So measurement of triangles, it studies the relation of the sides and angles of a triangle. Then how many sides are there? There are three sides in a triangle. So, and three angles in a triangle. It studies the relation between three sides and three angles of a triangle. Then who is the founder or father of trigonometry? In ancient Greek history, Hipparchus first used trigonometric concepts. He is the father of trigonometry. After that, so many mathematicians, astrologers have given their contribution to trigonometry. Our Indian mathematician Aryabhatta also gave some contribution to the trigonometry. In this way, that trigonometry branch is developed. Then, what are the uses of trigonometry? By studying what are the uses, we can find the heights of the tree or towers, the width of the roads, height of the tides in the oceans, the height of the trees or towers or mountains, which we cannot measure easily. Sometimes we cannot measure the heights and widths of the rivers. In that case, by using trigonometry, we can easily find. So, trigonometry useful in oceanography, that means study of oceans, and seismology. Seismology means study of earthquakes, and it has many applications in the almost all branches of sciences. For example, physics. There is a formula in physics 10th class mathematics mu is equal to sin a plus d by 2 by n by 2, sin a by 2. That is the refractive index of the triangular prism. Formula mu is equal to sin a plus d by 2 by sin a by 2. This is also trigonometric functions are used in this formula. Then in electricity there is a formula is there, F is equal to ILB sin theta. What is the force of the magnetic force on the current carrying conductor? Is F is equal to ILB sin theta, and phi is equal to BA cos theta. That is the magnetic flux in a plane can be measured by BA cos theta. In this, F is equal to ILB sin theta. So, electromagnetism chapter is there. In this way, so many formulas are there which are derived by using the trigonometric functions. So, we must learn trigonometry conceptually and thoroughly, then only we can understand the other branches of mathematics, or also we can study the other sciences by using this trigonometry. So, let us start the trigonometry. The beginning, we see this is a wall of a house. If we keep a ladder like this, it reaches the ground at here. So, a right angle triangle is formed. This is a ladder. Right angle triangle is formed here. So, this is called opposite side, opposite side to this angle theta. Angle is measured in theta, so this side is called adjacent side. If we keep a ladder by taking more less angle like this, what happens here? Adjacent side is increased, opposite side is decreased, but the hypotenuse is same whenever the angle is decreased. See here, we have two set squares in our compass box. This is a one set square, it is right angled scalene triangle, a right angle triangle, but it is a scalene. Different sides are there, here 60 degrees, 30 degrees, 90 degrees. Here 45 degrees, right angle isosceles triangle. Here theta is 45 degrees, 45 degrees, 90 degrees. So when angle is changed, the sides ratio also changed. See here, the sides are equal. When angle is 45 degrees, the sides are equal. When angle is 60 degrees, 30 degrees, the sides are different. So according to the sides, according to the angles, the sides will be changed in a right angle triangle. The same way here also, I will take an example. It is a unit circle. So here I have taken a ray like this. At first position, the ray is here. It rotates around its axis like this. It is called anti-clockwise direction. If it rotates like this, it is called clockwise direction. So what is the, how can we measure the amount of rotation? If you rotate like this, what is the amount of rotation? Can we measure in centimeters? No. This is called angle. The amount of rotation is called angle. Here 10, 20, 30 degrees, 40 degrees, 50 degrees, 60 degrees, 70 degrees, 80 degrees, 90 degrees. It is a perpendicular line. So 90 degrees between the previous position and final position. This ray is called initial ray. This is ray is called final ray. The rotation amount of rotation is called angle. Here that is 90 degrees. If it still rotates in the anti-clockwise direction like this, the angle between the initial ray and final ray is 180 degrees. This is called straight angle. If it still rotates like this, it 120, 200, 210, 230, like this 270 degrees, the angle between the initial ray and final ray is 270 degrees. Still it rotates like this, completes one rotation, the ray completes one rotation, means that is a complete angle, that is 360 degrees. Here 10, 20, see here, this is a 360 degrees. If it rotates like this, it is called clockwise direction. The clockwise, this is called anti-clockwise direction. Let us take a position here at 30 degrees and draw a perpendicular line from this point to the initial ray or x-axis, then a right angle triangle is formed. Here a right angle triangle is formed. This is called theta, here 30 degrees, and this is called hypotenuse, which is opposite to 90 degrees. This perpendicular line is opposite to this 30 degrees, so this is called opposite side, and this line is called adjacent side, which is adjacent to this theta degrees. This is also adjacent side, but it is not adjacent side because it is the longest side in the triangle and it is opposite to 90 degrees. Therefore, it is called hypotenuse, and this is adjacent side and this is opposite side. If we measure the distance ratio to the opposite side and hypotenuse, then what we get? Let us see there. Measure the distance here. When theta is equal to 30 degrees, theta means angle, any angle 30 degrees, the ratio to the opposite side and hypotenuse, this is adjacent side. So this theta, this is opposite side, this is hypotenuse. Hypotenuse, how can we find hypotenuse? This is always opposite to 90 degrees. Opposite to 90 degrees, hypotenuse. Opposite to some theta angle, that is opposite side. let us take here A, B, C, and this is adjacent side to theta degrees. Now let us find the ratio to the, here it is 22 centimeters and it is 11 centimeters. Here 11 centimeters, this is 22 centimeters in this triangle. So 11 by 22 is equal to 1 by 2. If I draw one more perpendicular line from any point, of course I will take here this one, and I measure the distance, the length of the side, this is 8 centimeters and this is 16 centimeters. So if I draw one more triangle, when 30 degrees angle is there, when 30 degrees angle, if you take 30 degrees angle, for example, then the here how much centimeters here 8 and this one 16 centimeters. You can do this activity. If you divide the opposite side with hypotenuse, in this case also you will get 8 1 8 8 2 16. If I take one more measurement and draw a perpendicular line from any point to the x axis, and I will measure like this, here the distance is 4 centimeters and here it is 8 centimeters. Small triangle, here 4 centimeters, here 8 centimeters, when angle is 30 degrees, when angle is 30 degrees, here 4 centimeters, 8 centimeters. So 8, 4 by 8, again you will get 1 by 2. So what can we conclude from this activity? If you draw a perpendicular line from any point on the this ray to the x axis or initial ray, this distance is called projection. Projection of the this ray at this point for this angle. So projection of this ray is this one at this point. Projection of the ray is this one at this point. So this projection is called adjacent side, and this is called opposite side, and this is called hypotenuse. So for taking particular angle, if you take any angle and take projections from any point, you will get same ratio, either 1 by 2 or 1 by 3, any ratio. For different angles you will get different ratio, but that ratio must be equal, that should be equal, it is always equal. In this way you can find this by taking an experiment. You can do in your notebook, do this activity, draw a 30 degrees rectangle triangle, take this like this, and draw a line like this, line segment, and take 30 or 40, whatever you like, any degrees, 30 degrees ray, such that this is A, B, X ray. Then draw a perpendicular line from this point and find the distance and divide by this distance by this one, you will get a fixed ratio. If you draw anywhere, divide this length by this length, you will get same ratio. For any small triangle also, here we get this is B, this is C, A, BC by AC is equal to DE by AE, you will get same value. FG by AG. If you draw a perpendicular line from any point to this x axis or previous initial ray, the ratio to the opposite side and hypotenuse is called, is the same, always same, do this activity. So here, what is the ratio to the opposite side, what we call here opposite side to ratio to opposite side and hypotenuse is called, first one, sine theta, it is called
sin theta. In this triangle, there are six ratios, trigonometric ratios. Sin theta is equal to this opposite side by adjacent side. Opposite side to theta is here this one. So opposite side to theta by hypotenuse. You can take the right angle triangle like this also. This is opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side by hypotenuse. This one. This is opposite side. This is hypotenuse. So the ratio to the opposite side to theta and hypotenuse is called sin theta. In the previous case, we got sin 30 degrees. We got 1/2. The ratio is like this always. This ratio is called sin theta. Means 30 degree opposite ratio to the opposite side and hypotenuse. If you take any big triangle or small triangle, you will get the same ratio. So then second one, the adjacent side by hypotenuse also you will get same ratio. In that case, that is called cosine theta. Cosine theta means adjacent ratio to the adjacent side by hypotenuse. If you take this triangle, let us write here, AB by AC is called sin theta, and adjacent side BC by AC is called cos theta. Then the ratio to the opposite side by adjacent side, this opposite side and adjacent side is called tangent theta. Opposite side to theta by adjacent side to theta. Opposite side to theta. Here like this, here also theta is there. Opposite side to theta is means opposite side to C also. We can write sin tan C also. So opposite side is equal, this is AB by BC. Now if we take the reciprocals of this, we will get other three trigonometric ratios. What is the reciprocal means? Inverse. So sin theta reciprocal is cosine, cosec or cosecant theta, and this is taken as hypotenuse by opposite side. Inverse or reciprocal to this, then you can take cosecant. Reciprocal to cosine is secant theta. Reciprocal means the inverse of this fraction, hypotenuse by adjacent side. Last one, tangent. Reciprocal of tangent is cotangent. Cotangent theta, that is adjacent side by opposite side. Adjacent side by opposite. Here cosecant means AC by AB. Here secant means AC by BC. Yes, cotangent means BC by AB. In this way we got six ratios in trigonometry. Opposite side by hypotenuse sin theta, its inverse hypotenuse by opposite side cosecant theta. Opposite side adjacent side by hypotenuse cos theta, hypotenuse by adjacent side secant theta. Opposite side by adjacent side tan theta, adjacent side by opposite side cotangent theta. But we write this six trigonometric ratios in abbreviation. Abbreviate these six trigonometric ratios means we write shortly. Sin theta can be written as simply SIN, sin, and cosine theta simply can be written as cos theta. Cosine can be written as COS, cos, first three letters of this tangent is tan theta. and this can be written as cosecant, cosec theta. It is taken as cosec theta, and it is taken as sec theta. Simply we can write it as sec theta. This is can be written as cot theta. This is the we can abbreviate these six trigonometries like this. Then sin theta is reciprocal to cosec theta, inverse. If we take any values for this, we can write that one. Here if we take a right angle triangle, this is, if we take this, it will be, if it is adjacent side is 3 degrees 3 centimeters, if opposite side is 4 centimeters, then automatically the hypotenuse will be 5 centimeters according to Pythagoras theorem. 3 square plus 4 square is equal to 5 square. 3 square plus 4 square according to Pythagoras theorem, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Therefore, AC square here, how can we get the AC square? Here 3 square BC 4 square, 9 plus 16. It is 25. So AC square equal to 25. AC is equal to square root of 25. That will be 5 centimeters. 5 centimeters. From this we can say sin theta, tan theta, count like this. Here sin theta is equal to opposite side by opposite side to theta is 4. Opposite side to theta. Opposite side to theta by hypotenuse. Here opposite side are 4 and hypotenuse is 5, 4 by 5. Cos theta is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. ADJ means adjacent side, hypotenuse, that is adjacent side by hypotenuse, that is equal to 3 by 5. Tan theta, you can write tan theta, that is opposite side by adjacent side, that is equal to 4 by 3. Then cosecant theta, cosec theta, we can reverse it, hypotenuse by opposite side, that is equal to 5 by 4. Then sec theta, we can take inverse of cos theta, hypotenuse by adjacent side, that is 5 by 3. Then cot theta is the inverse of tan theta, or reciprocal of tan theta, adjacent side by opposite side, that is equal to 3 by 4. In this way we can write all these trigonometric ratios from this triangle. Now let us multiply the sin theta with cosec theta. What do we get? Here sin theta is equal to 4 by 5, cosec theta is equal to 5 by 4. 4 by 5 into 5 by 4, 4 cancel, 5 1 5 cancel, we get 1. So sin theta into cosec theta is equal to 1. That means if we take same angles here, we get 1. Sin 10 into cosec 10, 1. Sin 30 into cosec 30, 1. Sin 45 into cosec 45, 1. Whatever you take the same angles, the product of these two angles will get, values will get 1 only. Second one, cos theta into its reciprocal sec theta. So cos theta its reciprocal sec theta. Cos theta is equal to 3 by 5. Its reciprocal sec theta 5 by 3, from that result both will get cancel, you will get 1 only. So cos theta into sec theta also 1. Similarly tan theta into cot theta, tan theta and its reciprocal cot theta, cot cot, tan theta is 4 by 3 there and cot theta is 3 by 4, both will get cancel, you will get 1. So product of sin theta and cosec theta is equal to 1, product of sin theta and cos theta and sec theta 1, product of tan theta and cot theta also 1. If you take same angles here, you will get the result 1. So from this we can write some more formulas. Sin theta is equal to if we transpose this cosec theta that side, right hand side 1 by cosec theta, sin theta is equal to 1 by cosec theta because it is reciprocal. Or cosec theta is equal to, cosec theta is equal to transpose sin theta right side, you will get 1 by sin theta. From this result we can write cos theta is equal to 1 by sec theta by transposition. This becomes here into is there, becomes reciprocal denominator 1 by sec. Or sec theta is equal to 1 by cos theta. Then tan theta is equal to, tan theta is equal to 1 by cot theta by transpose, we get 1 by cot theta. Enter into is there, become reciprocal denominator. Or cot theta is equal to 1 by tan theta. These are the formula you have to remember. All these formulas you have to remember in order to do the solve the problems easily. You must remember all these formulae. So we can write one more formula also here. If you divide sin theta by cos theta, what will you get? If you divide sin theta by cos theta. Sin theta means, you know the definition of sin theta, opposite side by hypotenuse. And cos theta means adjacent side by hypotenuse. If you divide one fraction by another fraction, what do you, how to divide? Opposite side by hypotenuse into hypotenuse by adjacent side. To divide one fraction by another fraction, write the first fraction as it is and multiply with reciprocal of the second fraction, reverse. So here hypotenuse, hypotenuse cancel, adjacent side opposite by adjacent side. Then what is opposite side by adjacent, what is the ratio to the opposite side adjacent side? See here, opposite side by adjacent side is tan theta. So if you divide sin theta with cos theta, you will get tan theta. Similarly, if you divide cos theta by sin theta, what do you get? Cos theta is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse and sin theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. In this way, you can write here also, you can cancel here, but adjacent side by hypotenuse into reciprocal of this one, hypotenuse by opposite side. Hypotenuse cancel, we get adjacent side by opposite side. What is adjacent side by opposite side? Adjacent side by opposite side, we get cot theta. So in this way, these are the basic and important formulae in the trigonometry. First one, sin theta, cos theta, tan theta, cosec theta, sec theta, cot theta. There are 6 trigonometric ratios. Because there are 3 sides only, that's why there are 6 trigonometric ratios. And the reciprocal of the one trigonometric ratio with other will be give the product of the one trigonometric ratio and its reciprocal is equal to 1. Sin theta into cosec theta 1, cos theta into sec theta 1, tan theta into cot theta 1. Sin theta is equal to 1 by cosec theta is equal to 1 by sin theta, cos theta is equal to 1 by sec theta is equal to 1 by cos theta. Tan theta is equal to 1 by cot theta is equal to 1 by tan theta, sin theta by cos theta is equal to tan theta, cos theta by sin theta is equal to cot theta. So in this way we have to remember all these formulae or basic principles. So here this is a trigonometry, this is a circle, this is the opposite side, this is the adjacent side, this is hypotenuse. Opposite side means opposite side to which degree, whom? It is opposite side to theta degree, here theta, opposite side to theta, this is opposite side, this is adjacent side and this is hypotenuse. Okay. Memorize all these ratios, definitions of these ratios.